Today on Two Crazy Ketos, we're going to talk about a very touchy subject with some people. We're going to talk about lazy keto versus dirty keto versus strict keto.
We will talk about the differences and find out which one is best
right after this.
Hey, what's up, family? I'm Rachel.
And I'm Joe.
And we are Two Crazy Ketos.
If you're new to our channel, welcome. Here on Two Crazy Ketos, we do different things like product reviews. We do recipe videos. We talk about various keto topics. And then once a week, we sit down on the couch for Keto on the Couch. We just kind of talk about what's going on in our lives for the week.
You can find us on different social media platforms like Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter.
And we also have a website, which is twocrazyketos.com. And that's where you're going to find all of our different recipes. Now, we do upload at least 5 new videos every single week. So make sure you subscribe to our channel.
And don't forget to hit the little bell icon. And that way, every single time we upload a new video, you'll be alerted to it.
Yeah. So today we're going to talk about a very touchy subject with some people.
Are we going to get in trouble?
Probably, but that's okay.
All right.
So we're going to talk about the 3 different types of keto that everybody talks about. Lazy keto, dirty keto, and strict keto.
I don't even like the term dirty.
I can't stand the term dirty keto.
There's a lot of shame in that,
yeah,
right?
And we'll get into why, but it's just, first of all, it's a newer term.
Yeah.
You know, but there's a reason people call it dirty keto. And we're going to compare what the 3 different types of keto are and then try to determine which one is the best one or who's right.
Yeah.
Because there's a lot of people like, well, if you're not doing it this way, you're not doing it correctly.
I don't like that judgy stuff.
Yeah, I definitely don't like the keto police kind of attitude.
Yeah.
Right? So I think we need to start off is what is the definition of keto?
Okay.
Okay, so the definition of keto is very simple. And that's why I don't like really any of these terms. But all the definition of keto is it is eating a high-fat, moderate-protein, low-carbohydrate diet.
It's not Atkins.
It's not Atkins. It's not like, oh my, you know, keto, it means you absolutely can't have canola oil.
Right.
It's got one definition. High-fat, low-carb, moderate-protein.
So there's a lot of food in there. There's right. a lot of food that, like, you hit the checkbox, thumbs up. You're eating keto.
Right.
If that's what you're trying to accomplish is keto.
Right. And you have to remember, where did keto start? Keto started in the 1920s to work with epilepsy.
The goal was not weight loss.
Right.
The goal was mental clarity, mental function, what could be done to move people, patients, in the right direction when they were like dealing with certain medical issues.
Right. And it comes down to of which camp do you want to do, whether it be lazy, dirty, or strict keto, with what are you trying to accomplish?
Yeah.
If you're trying to accomplish what, like, the original invention of the ketogenic diet is, which is, like, the mental clarity for epilepsy and, you know, maybe cancer and things
Alzheimer's.
Like that, then you're going to do it very differently than someone who's just trying to drop a few pounds.
Exactly. Exactly. Okay.
So I think we should start off with the one we don't like the most, right? The term dirty keto.
I don't like that.
Right.
Stop it. Stop calling it that.
Okay, so dirty keto, which I guess we could say that's where we started, right?
Yeah.
So dirty keto is basically following the ketogenic diet,
mm-hmm.
okay, high fat, moderate protein, low carbohydrate diet.
Yes.
You're tracking everything. You're tracking your calories, you're tracking, you know, your macros and your fat intake and keeping your carbohydrates underneath. But you're willing to eat junk food. You're willing to eat fast food.
Okay.
You're willing to eat canola oil, you know, regular eggs, not pasture-raised eggs, you know, regular ground beef, that kind of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what dirty keto is. You know, people who, like, go to the grocery store and are willing to get, I don't know, Russell Stover's candies because it says,
sugar-free
on it, and mm-hmm. you look at the carbohydrates, and the carbohydrates are low in it. You know, they pretty much have the attitude of, if it fits in my macros, I'm going to eat it.
Yeah.
That's pretty much the really dumbed down definition of dirty keto.
Okay.
Okay. And here's the thing. Is it the best camp to be in? Probably not.
Depends on what you're trying to accomplish.
It depends on what you're trying to accomplish. If you're just trying to accomplish losing some weight.
You will lose weight.
You will lose some weight. Again, depending on your body.
Mm-hmm.
But you may not get all of the benefits of the ketogenic diet, you know, because you could still be eating inflammatory foods. You know, you could still be eating things that could spike your blood sugar, things like, you know, eating certain types of sugar-free candies. It's going to have maltitol in it. It's going to have sorbitol in it. you know, those kind of products will spike your insulin and can affect your overall ketogenic lifestyle.
But here's the thing. This is what grinds my gears, is if I've made any of the choices going in the direction of keto, that means that I have said no to some of my old eating habits.
Right.
And I think that that should be celebrated.
Absolutely.
Not shamed, because if I'm picking up a Russell Stover's sugar-free candy, that means that I've put down the Sour Patch Kids that I used to be eating by the 5-pound bag.
Right.
Which was a thing. That was happening. So every, like, thing that you do in the right direction, like when we gave up bread, when we gave up pasta, when we gave up rice, I think every single one of those should be celebrated.
Right.
Not, like, shamed, like you're not doing enough yet.
Right.
You know, as we started experiencing more mental clarity, we started feeling better, that encouraged me to take the next step in the direction of a more stricter keto lifestyle.
Right.
Shaming me does not make me make good decisions.
Right.
Shaming me makes me want to give up altogether. If you've labeled me as dirty, then I just want to go ahead and live up to that terminology that you've given me.
Right.
So I think that that is what I don't like about it.
That's why I hate the term, because I feel the same way. My feeling is this, is if you're going into the grocery store and you're not buying bread and you're not buying pasta and you're not buying white rice and you're not buying potato chips and all the sugar, and instead of that, you're picking up what super strict keto people would call not keto foods, things like low carb tortillas,
mm-hmm.
or like maybe things that have some rice flour in it, which nobody is, every rice flour is still kind of on the fence of whether
yeah.
it's like really good for you or not good for you, anything like that. But if you're picking up that stuff, if you're picking up a dozen eggs instead of like the Jimmy Dean's frozen soft breakfast sandwiches.
Can we just say we love you and we're proud of you and we celebrate
right.
these decisions going in the right direction?
You're moving in the right direction. And that's my feeling. And I think that most people do start with a dirtier type of keto. That's where we started, you know, buying Hellman's mayonnaise, you know, buying, you know, all of those different types of products.
We started with hot dogs and mustard.
Right. And that's the thing, is that Dr. Barry talks about that all the time. He was like, listen, here's where you want to end up, but if you can only afford to start on hot dogs and mustard, it's better than you were doing, right?
Yeah.
Now, there are some downsides, like we said, to dirty keto. Some of them would be, like we said, maybe you're still eating some inflammatory products. So if you're eating something that could have like effects on your inflammation, if you have like different types of diseases, if you have arthritis, you
yeah.
may not be able to get rid of them all because you're taking in products which lead to that inflammation.
So you are losing weight,
right?
But your joints may still be hurting,
right?
So sometimes, you know, because people are in different, like on different levels of keto, when you hear somebody who's maybe practicing a stricter keto talk about like, wow, my joints feel great and my muscles feel great and everything feels great, and you're like, well, wait a second, that's not what I'm experiencing. I'm experiencing weight loss, but I still feel very inflamed. That's probably just because they've tweaked their diet and gotten rid of some of those oils,
right.
which is what we have done.
Right.
But it's not where we started.
Right. Now, the other problem that you could have with dirty keto is maybe you're not eating all of the right macronutrients, you know, not eating all of the vegetables that you should be eating. A lot of times people who do dirty keto are pretty much like, I'm just going to eat butter, bacon, and ground beef, and like, I don't care about everything else. But you're not getting all of your nutrients. You're
yeah.
not getting all of your electrolytes. You're not balancing everything out.
And when you do that, you can experience some other side effects like hair loss.
Mm-hmm.
You can have some constipation.
Yep.
Things, because, you know, your body does need a well-balanced
right.
diet. So that may be part of the reason why you're experiencing that, if that's a side effect that you're thinking is just a keto side effect, but it's not necessarily, like, everybody isn't experiencing that depending on what they're eating.
Right. And for me, I think the biggest problem with dirty keto, and again, I'm not saying it's wrong. I think it's a great place to start,
yes.
which is where we started. The biggest problem now that keto has become mainstream is that you have more and more companies who are preying on the fact that, you know, a lot of us do eat like a dirty keto lifestyle.
Yeah.
And so they're putting in even more questionable foods, which aren't really keto.
And hoping that they don't get caught.
Hoping they don't get caught. Because, and that's where you have to be careful.
Yeah. Because they do know that sometimes, I mean, especially for our like fast, lives. You know, dirty keto, at least for a portion, a season of our life, we had to do it that way because we were on the go. You had to have more grab-and-go snacks. You had to go have more grab-and-go entree options, especially like when the kids were a little bit younger. So, you know, they're preying on that.
Right.
They're hoping that they don't get caught.
Yep. And there was really the two biggest reasons that people do dirty keto and stay dirty keto is either A, you know, they do live a super busy lifestyle, so they need to be able to eat some on-the-go things, eat things like lunch meats and stuff like that, which we all know isn't the greatest, does have fillers, but it's still better than you were.
Exactly.
And the other thing is some people just can't afford to eat only grass-fed beef, only pasture-raised eggs and that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
And that's okay. If you're doing that, if you're eating regular ground beef, if you're eating regular eggs, but you're not eating the sugar and the flour and stuff like that, I know we keep repeating that,
mm-hmm.
you're doing better. And don't let anybody shame you that you're not really doing keto. You're eating low carb. I saw somebody do a live stream the other day about that. And excuse me, it just like, it irked me where she was like, if you're not doing perfect strict keto, if you're eating anything other than grass-fed meat, if she's like, then you're not keto and stop calling yourself keto. She's like, you're only doing low carb. And I did everything I could to like not comment in the comment section that you are shaming people.
My mom face goes into full bloom when I see somebody, like getting on somebody over it when they're trying their best and they're doing stuff. My advice would be if it is an affordability situation, stick to whole foods.
Right. And we'll get into that with the strict keto.
Yeah.
So let's talk about the next one. Let's talk about lazy keto.
I kind of like that terminology a little bit better because sometimes I choose to be lazy and I like being lazy sometimes, but it still kind of has a negative connotation.
Okay, well, lazy keto, let's talk about what is lazy keto. So lazy keto is pretty much following a good ketogenic diet.
Mm-hmm.
It's eating healthier foods, really trying to eliminate like all of the bad oils and stuff like that, but sometimes you will still incorporate it.
Yeah.
The biggest difference between like lazy keto and both strict and dirty keto is that lazy keto is pretty much you track your carbohydrates and nothing else.
Oh, okay.
Okay, so lazy people don't count their calories. They don't count their fat. They don't count their, you know, the amount of protein they're eating. It's, I'm keeping my carbs under 20 and that's all I care about.
All right.
And there's some positives and some negatives to this. My personal belief is I don't think lazy keto is a good place to start.
I like the fact that there's less math. There's clearly less math in this method.
Well, you still have math in the carbohydrates.
True.
So like the reason I say it's not a good place to start is because especially if you're looking to lose weight, no matter what benefit you're looking at on the ketogenic diet,
mm-hmm.
it's going to be difficult to achieve that if you're not tracking everything.
If you're never thinking about calories.
Right.
If you're never thinking about the quantity of food that you eat.
Yeah.
If you're just talking about the carbohydrates. And there's no other element to the food. Like, yeah, I can see where that would
Yeah, and I think
one-sided.
A lot of times we eat a form of lazy keto. We kind of go back and forth between a strict, a little dirty, and lazy.
Certainly when we get on challenges and we're trying to accomplish something,
we get super strict.
So there it is too. Like, what are your goals and how long do you want to allow these to be achieved?
Right.
Right? Because if you're like, hey, if I can be, you know, I can lose 30 pounds 5 years from now,
right,
then your keto journey can look a lot different. You can take a lot more time to accomplish that. But for us, if we're trying to do a cut or we're trying to accomplish something in a shorter amount of time, then yeah, we get more and more strict.
Right. Especially because with lazy keto, the bottom line is, like I said, they don't usually count calories in the lazy keto camp.
Mm-hmm.
And the bottom line is calories matter. It's not just calories, but calories matter. Calories matter. The amount of exercise you do matters. Like the types of foods matter. Are you snacking? It all of that matters. What is your metabolism like? So when you do lazy keto, the only thing you're counting is your carbs, and it can have some good results, especially at the beginning. If you're somebody, you know, like us, who you were just off the deep end eating 30,000 calories a day and eating lots of sugar and going into the bathroom or going into your truck and eating Hershey bars so that your spouse can't find it.
Right here.
And all of a sudden you just cut all of that stuff out, you're going to see some results.
I think that my bathroom garbage can is shocked at the fact that there's no more Reese's peanut butter cup wrappers in it anymore, because there used to be a whole lot of those in there, because I would eat in the bathroom where you couldn't find it, And yeah, so if you're making the switch from living the Reese's peanut butter cup bathroom life that I was living, and you're going and going to choose to do lazy keto, like, bravo again.
It's still better than you were doing.
Exactly.
And that's what, you know, I tell people all the time, if you're thinking about keto, if you're not ready to jump completely on a ketogenic lifestyle, mm-hmm. but you want to kind of get your feet wet, lazy keto is a great place to start. And that's where we tell people, when you first start the keto lifestyle, the first week or so, just do lazy keto. Keep your carbs under 20. When you're hungry, eat fat. And then after a week or two, then you can move up to the next step.
And I can see the benefit. For one thing, you are starting to have to make a decision for yourself. If you're saying, well, I'm going to be counting my carbs, I'm going to hold up that oatmeal, I'm going to hold up that rice, I'm going to hold up that pasta, and I'm going to see right away, wow, something is going to have to give. Either right. I'm going to have to put down this rice, I'm going to have to put down this pasta, I'm going to have to put down this bread, or I'm going to have to put down the rest of the bulk of my food. I'm going to have to make a choice, though.
Right.
Like, something's got to go. And trust me, you figure out pretty quickly, you know what's going to be easier? I'm going to get way more food if I put down this oatmeal, because I can either have this much oatmeal or I can have a plate full of food that doesn't have a bunch of carbohydrates in it.
Right.
So for Rachel, who likes to eat, that was an easy give the carbs away. I'm not going to eat the rice. I'm not going to eat the flour. But it forced me to deal with my relationship with food and make a choice for myself, not just let my meals happen to me. So that's a good place to start for some people.
Right. Now, ultimately, what I believe the best thing for lazy keto, or the best time to utilize a lazy keto, is when you're in maintenance mode.
Yes.
Okay, so once you reach your goal, once you've achieved what you're trying to achieve, lazy keto becomes a little bit better because it makes the keto lifestyle more sustainable.
Yeah.
You know, I really believe that, like, as far as being super strict keto and tracking every single bite that goes in your mouth, tracking every single macro, that could be tedious, it could be time consuming, it could be stressful.
Yeah.
And can ultimately cause you to, like, I just don't want to do this anymore.
Yeah. And we don't want you to rage quit this life.
Right.
Right.
I mean, we're looking at this as long term. So that is really where the benefit of lazy keto comes in. And then every once in a while, you kind of have to tighten the reins back in, because like anything else, like, you start getting out of control, you forget, like, oh my gosh, I forgot what a portion size is supposed to be. And you start increasing your food.
Yeah.
But then you can dial it back a little bit.
Yeah. You have the base knowledge of, like, how much broccoli am I supposed to have? Like, how much meat in a portion should I have? Like, you kind of know that. Those numbers stay in your head, like, because you've gone and made those decisions in the past, like, should I choose asparagus, a salad, like, what should be my size to this meal? You've already gone through that for a while. And so, yeah, when you're in maintenance mode, like, it's easier to do that, but still be, like, correct in your choices.
Right, because you start figuring out exactly, like, you know, you learn your body and you know what your body needs.
Yeah.
So let's talk about strict keto.
Okay.
Now, before we even talk about strict keto in itself and whether it's right or wrong, let's talk about exactly what it is.
Mm-hmm.
So strict keto is, you know, following all of your macros, tracking your carbohydrates, tracking, you know, your protein, your fat intake. Usually strict keto people use a tracking calculator, like,
yeah,
you know, chronometer or something like that. They count all of their calories. Usually with strict keto, you're avoiding any kind of processed oils, things like canola oil, corn oil, sunflower oil.
Sweeteners.
Sweeteners. A lot of times they completely eliminate all sweeteners. You know, you're only eating for oils, things like coconut oil, avocado oil, you know, butter, ghee, lard, fat. A lot of times strict keto people even eliminate all dairy because it could lead to inflammation.
Yeah.
Usually it's only grass-fed meats, pasture-raised eggs kind of stuff. And it's just a very, very strict form of keto. It basically eliminating anything that could possibly, you know, like, cause inflammation. Usually it's no processed foods, including keto processed foods.
Yeah, no, there's no keto snacks that are, like, in a package.
Yeah, so whole foods, pretty much. You know, like, only eating fresh vegetables. A lot of times strict people won't even eat frozen vegetables, which many times can be healthier than the fresh vegetables.
And there's a lot of benefits to that.
I mean,
really, you kind of, if you're in the keto lifestyle for not just weight loss, but also all of the health benefits, you know, the further strict you are, like, the stricter you are, you know, the more benefits you're going to experience. Like right. when you're working those oils out of your life, you're not going to experience inflammation. You know, right. you're not going to have the brain fog if you are, you know, practicing a strict keto life. It's a fun place to be because you feel really good because, as you can imagine, a lot of that processed stuff, you know, can weigh you down.
Right. It just, you know, for some people, it's much harder to maintain. We live a pretty strict keto life, but we're certainly not perfectly strict. We still enjoy some keto snacks.
Yeah.
You know, but for the most part, we try to eat a stricter keto lifestyle where we don't really like to have the canola oils and stuff like that. You know, but again, there is nothing that says that the ketogenic diet says you can't have canola oils. You shouldn't have canola oil for other reasons because it's not good for you.
Yeah.
You know, the bottom line, it's a poison. It causes inflammation. It's just not a good, healthy oil for you to be eating.
Yeah.
But as far as keto, it's still better than eating sugar.
Exactly.
You know,
exactly.
To a point.
And even for us, like, you know, we try to track stuff, but like we are not always budgeting all of the time to put every single mouthful of food into Chronometer.
Right.
You know, every day. Like you don't always have time to do that. And I don't think you should be shamed for it.
Right. And that's the one thing about like that I get a little annoyed with some strict people, not everybody,
mm-hmm.
but where you go in and to, especially you find this in forums where you find somebody who like is super strict keto and they want to be the keto police and they start yes. shaming people. Like if you went and had something that was deep fried in canola oil, if you went and had wings anywhere other than going to Buffalo Wild Wings or making them yourself, then you're not keto. Don't call yourself keto.
And that will bring out my mom face like you can't even believe, because my thing is, we are hard enough on ourselves
right.
without an outside person getting on us about stuff. So if you experience negativity, somebody's trying to make you feel bad because you're not as strict as them or you're not, you know, doing this keto thing the way they're doing it, like click off, close right. out. Like we're not doing that because you don't need that negativity in your life. And we are super proud of you for the good choices that you're making. And I want you to stick with this and not be like shamed out of the whole keto community because, you know, you had chicken wings from some restaurant that right. wasn't Buffalo Wild Wings, right? Right.
So let's talk about which one is the right one. And I know that's what you're watched for, right? And I hate to say this, they're all keto. They really are all keto. They're different levels of keto.
Yeah.
If you want my personal opinion, and I think Rachel can say the same thing, your ultimate goal should be to move towards a stricter form of keto.
Yeah.
It doesn't mean eliminating things like keto bricks.
Right.
It doesn't mean that you could never have like a Killer Creamery ice cream or you could never have a smart cake or anything like that. But I think that your ultimate goal should lead towards, you know, 70, 80, 90% of your diet is not including that stuff and having that stuff as a treat.
Right.
You know, I think that if you are on a more of a dirty keto, which again, we hate that term, but if you're on a dirty keto lifestyle, I think you do it the way we did it, where you slowly start eliminating some of the things that aren't healthy. For example, the first thing that we did was we switched from regular eggs to pasteurized eggs.
Yeah.
Now, when did we switch from regular eggs to pasteurized eggs? When we started to realize that, hey, I've got some extra money in my food budget that I wasn't spending before.
Right.
And that money came from the fact that we weren't buying the potato chips. We weren't buying the candy bars and the cookies and all that stuff.
Because they're not always cheap either.
Right.
When we cut out the McDonald's budget, when I cut out my Starbucks budget, then I was able to put that money someplace else and I just got a better quality of food. Once we started eating that, we started feeling good. We would notice a difference in the taste.
Right.
And that is just kind of, we got naturally led into a more stricter lifestyle, not shamed into a stricter lifestyle.
Right.
You know, that's what we don't want you to do.
And again, our goal is to have as many people turn to keto as possible, not just for weight loss, but for all of the other health benefits. And if you start telling somebody, if you have sucralose in your like coffee, then you're not keto. Now, I said sucralose, not Splenda. Splenda is absolutely not keto because it's got maltodextrin and dextrose in it, and it's not a low-carbohydrate sweetener.
Yeah.
But sucralose is. It's just an artificial sweetener, and right. it's a zero on the glycemic index.
Yeah.
That's a tangent. But anyway, but if you start telling people you have to do it this way or no way, not as many people are going to switch over. So starting off on dirty keto, in my personal opinion, and again, we're not doctors, but my personal opinion, is a perfectly good place to start.
Yeah.
Now, if you're starting to experience a stall, if you're starting to experience like, hey, I've got a little bit of brain fog, or hey, I've got a little bit of inflammation that wasn't there before.
Listen to your body.
Listen to your body and start transitioning something out. Like pick something. Probably the first thing to do, pull out dairy. See if it's the dairy thing. Start eliminating some of the oils. Switch from a Hellman's mayonnaise to, you know, an avocado oil mayonnaise, either a store-bought one or one that you make yourself.
But isolate each thing so that you can tweak it. If you, like, pull everything out at once, you won't know what's causing it.
And we've made that mistake where we said, oh, we're going to change, like, 20 things at once. Well, now what was causing the problem?
Right. I didn't know if it was I had an issue with dairy or I had an issue with an oil. Like, right. I just didn't know because we had done it both at the same time. So isolate things. You know, experiment. We're always doing things like a beef and butter challenge. We did like keto bricks for a week. We did like egg fast and stuff like that. So all of those things will help you to tweak and find out and talk to your body and communicate and see like, what do I need to experiment with and what does my body respond to the most?
Right. So that is our video for today. I'm sure that you're at the end of it going, well, you didn't answer which one is best. And again, I think we did. The best one really is strict keto. But it's not the only answer. Even if you're doing lazy keto, even if you're doing, you know, a dirty keto, you're still doing keto and you're better off than you were and you should applaud yourself.
And you know what I think? The best keto plan is the one that is sustainable in your life.
That's right. Well, that is our video for today. Let us know what your opinions are. I don't know if I want to ask that, but I'm going to ask you anyway. Let us know your opinion down below. Is there anything that we missed that maybe we should have discussed with one of these? Let us know down in the comments section. If you like what you saw today, do us a favor. Hit that like button down below.
And don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the little bell icon. And that way, every single time we upload a new video, you'll be alerted to it.
Until next time.
Bye.
Bye.